Good day and welcome back. In this video, we are going to continue Chapter 1, Dimensional Analysis. The objective of this video today is to use the dimensional axis to help us to check the homogeneity of the equations and to construct empirical equations. So we have learned about the dimensions of those best quantities and the derived quantities in the previous video. And now let us look at one question in past year 2017. The velocity v of a standing wave produced by a string is related to its tension f, length l, and mass m. Which equation shows a possible relationship between those variables if k is a dimensionless quantity? So this is a question that you never learned about the formula before. So what we can do here is to perform the dimensional axis to check the homogeneity of the equations to determine the possible formulas. Before we proceed, you should understand that the dimension of velocity is the length per time, so it is L per T. And then we're going to check the dimension of the right-hand side equations for each of the answer. So K is a dimensionless, which means it don't have a dimension. So the dimension of the force is ML per T squared, which we learned in the previous video, and the length is L, and the mass is M. So if you have the square root in the equations, just convert it into the form of indices, which is 2 to the power of 1 over 2. So put in the dimension of each of the variables, and then you can simplify the equations using the knowledge of indices. So in the end, you should obtain the dimension of L per T, which is the same as the dimension of velocity. And for practice purpose, you also can perform the dimensional analysis on the answer B, C, and D. And I will list the answer here for your own reference. Next, we're going to look at another question from the trial paper of SMJK Chung, Confucian in 2022. We are given with these Bernoulli equations where the P is the pressure, V is the velocity, and H is the height of the point. So with the limited knowledge that we have, we are going to determine the dimension of the alpha and the beta in the equations. First of all, in order to have this equation to be a valid equation is that every term in the equations should have the same dimension. First, we need to identify the dimension of the pressure, which can be expressed as the formula of the force per area. So you can use another formula as well, but I will proceed with the force per area. We have the dimension of the force as ML per T squared, and the dimension of the area is L squared. So simplifying the expression, you should obtain the dimension of the pressure is M per L per T squared. And then we're going to look at the second term in the equations, which is the alpha v squared. So the dimension of the alpha v squared should be the same as the dimension of the pressure. So we have obtained the dimension of the pressure is m per L per T squared. And we learn about the dimension of the velocity is L per T. So from here, we can obtain the dimension of the alpha by dividing the dimension of P with the dimension of v squared. So simplify the expression, you should obtain the dimension of the alpha is m per L cubed. And then now we're going to do the same thing in the third term, beta h. So this is easier than the second term that we have the dimension of height is L. So dividing the dimension of the pressure with the length, we have the dimension of the beta as m per L squared per T squared. So this is how we can apply the dimensional analysis to obtain the dimension of the unknown variables. To summarize the dimensional analysis, it can be used to confirm the homogeneity of equations with the condition that every term in the equations must have the same dimension. However, we still couldn't confirm if the equation is valid due to several reasons. For example, you use the wrong constant value in the equations, such as the formula of elastical potential energy that it should be half fx squared. Second reason is that you use an incomplete equations such as s equal to ut, and this is wrong when the accelerations of the object is a non-zero value. And the third reason could be contain incorrect terms such as the acceleration is equal to u plus v over t. This is wrong because it should be the change in velocity v minus u divided by t equal to the accelerations. So to confirm the validity of the equations, what we can do is to perform experiments and to construct empirical equations. Let us try one equation from the trial paper of SMK Tinggi Melaka in 2018. You are given with the equations of x equal to y to the power of m and z to the power of n. and the dimension of x, y, and z are given in the questions. So what you're going to do now is to find out the values of the m and n. And you do not know what are the actual variables represented by x, y, and z. So you know about that. So we need to make sure the dimension of the left-hand side is equal to the dimension of the right-hand side of the equations. On the left-hand side of the equations, dimension of x is equal to lt. While for the right-hand side, we have the formula of y to the power m and z to the power n. So put in the dimension of y and z, and you should have obtained the equation shown in the slide. Simplify the right-hand side equations, and you should obtain Lt is equal to L to the power of 2m plus n, t to the power of negative m plus 2n. What you're going to do is to compare the indices of respective variables. For example, from the variables L, we can obtain the equations of 1 equal to 2m plus n, and from variables t, we can obtain 1 equal to negative m plus 2n as the second equations. So you have two unknowns and two equations. So the next step is to perform simultaneous equations. So you can either do substitutions or eliminations. It is on you. So after doing the simultaneous, you should obtain the answer of m is equal to 1 over 5 and n is equal to 3 over 5. And then we're going to try another more complex questions also from SMK Tinggi Melaka in 2019. The orbital period T of the planet about the Sun is related to the distance R from the Sun as shown in the equations. You also have the mass of the Sun M and also the gravitational constant G, which we discussed in the previous video. And now what you're going to do is to determine the values of X, Y, and Z. So first of all, you should know that 4 pi squared has no dimension. And the question also gave you the dimension of G in terms of units, which is meter cubed per kilogram per second squared, and in terms of dimension, it is equal to L cubed per m per t squared. So what we're going to do next is to determine the dimension of each of the terms in the equations. We have the period as t, the mass as m, the distance as L. So now we're going to put in the dimension of each of the terms into the equations. We have the dimension of the period t to the power of x is equal to the dimension of m to the power of y, L to the power of Z divided by the dimension of the gravitational constant. Simplify the equations, you should obtain T to the power of X is equal to M to the power of Y plus 1, L to the power of Z minus 3, and T squared. So you can take a note here that on the left-hand side, we can add the terms of M to the power of 0 and L to the power of 0 for the comparison. So for the variables M, we have 0 is equal to Y plus 1, which gives us Y is equal to negative 1. Next is the variable L. We have the equations of 0 equal to z minus 3, which gives us z equal to 3. And lastly is the variables t. We have x is equal to 2. Finally, we have x equal to 2, while y equal to negative 1, and z equal to 3. Which brings us the equations of 4 pi squared r cubed over gm. And you might feel familiar with these equations that is from the Kepler's third law that you learned in Form 4 physics. So that's conclude my discussion for today. If you still have any questions, you can leave it in the comment section or fill in the Google form. Also, do leave a like and subscribe my channel. I will see you in my next video. Thank you.